have your license with you?
I'm a bartender.
All right. Your speech is a little slurred. Your eyes are glassy and watery.
Can I wait for my mother and my attorney to show up?
Your attorney for what?
I would rather wait for my mother to come pick me up. I'd rather wait for my attorney, if that's the case.
All right. I'm going to put you under.
Okay. I said your hand's shaking and mine's not. I know my law and I know my rights.
What's up, everybody? In today's video, we'll be taking a look at another drunk driving Karen getting herself arrested. Now, this one already caused an accident, so the cops are responding after the fact, and she is very entitled, very arrogant. She says she knows her rights, but she is so wrong on so many levels. It is unreal. Without further ado, let's get right into it.
No, but I know my driver's license number.
Do you have your license with you?
No.
Do you have a license?
Yes.
Is it valid?
Okay, copy.
Yes. Okay, this is your vehicle?
Yeah.
It's registered to you?
It's
okay, stand by.
Here,
second tag is going to be a Florida registration. Edward Nora Henry, X-ray 90, ENHX 90. Black Chrysler 300. Does it start up? Can you turn it on?
It says it's on.
Okay. All right. Perfect. Let's pull you over here into the gas station, okay?
Yeah.
It doesn't turn? No. Still doesn't turn? No. Okay. All right, can you get insurance information and your registration down? Okay. Do you have AAA?
No.
No? Okay.
535
Yeah, this one doesn't move.
Okay.
What's your name? What is it? Yeah, it comes back to her. Attack.
Here you go.
No medical attention or anything like that?
No.
Can you tell me what happened?
So I want to address all the idiots that say on the internet that drunk driving is a victimless crime. Look at this. This is the proof that when you're drunk, you're more likely to cause an accident. It's so strange because there's so much hate for the police online that some people throw their logic away. Drunk drivers are a serious danger to society and should be arrested on the spot every single time. And sentences should be a lot more steep than they currently are.
That's your last name, one at the end of the
car. Let's go ahead and get out of the car. We're going to go over to the sidewalk, okay? That way nobody hits us again.
How can anyone hit us again?
All right. Do you have any shoes?
Yeah, my work shoes.
Okay. Where do you work at? I can't hear you, I'm sorry.
Surfside Top House.
It's Top House? Oh, okay. Bartender?
I was.
Bartender. You heard all, ma'am. We're going to be right on the corner of South Bay and Hercules. It's on the New York South Pizzeria Shop.
Right in front of the shop there. Okay, I'll send it to you. Alright, bye. Where's Courtney? Hey, did Madison get her car yet? Okay. Alright. Alright, I'll pay you back.
No, I don't know who's. I think
Paloma. He said he's taking it, but I don't know if you need me. No.
Yeah, I'm good right now. I mean, the car. I was just trying to get the car out of the road, but it won't. She can't turn the wheel.
No, so the when it happens and the, what is it? It's all new. I don't know. It won't do it. Once the key fob, the battery's dead in the key fob, so it won't even acknowledge.
How much
it.
Have you had to drink tonight?
Okay, well, we're talking about my car.
Well, I'm asking you about how much have you had to drink.
Nothing?
Nothing?
No.
Mexico order alcohol in your beverage.
Okay, well, I'm a bartender at a bar.
Okay, what does that have to do with anything about being on your breath?
I don't know, because when I top a keg, the beer sits there and comes in my face. So I don't know what to tell you.
So it's on your breath? It gets on your breath that way?
I'm not arguing with you. My car will not turn because of clearing the key fob. It has nothing to do with anything else. Okay.
So you can see that as soon as she's questioned about drinking alcohol, she got extremely defensive and she's like, well, I work at a bar. Like, the officer is supposed to be like, okay, then since you work at a bar, you can drive drunk, no problem. This Karen is unreal. She might be more quiet than the other Karens we see on this channel, but she's extremely manipulative and deceptive.
Yeah, I smelled it on her breath, and she's like, her eyes are glassy and watery. She's slow and lethargic. She's got a little bit of slur in her speech too.
Hello. So I have a record coming here to pick up my car. Okay. Based on the statements on there, your statement, and you look at the bus, I just thought you're going to call me crash. I want to get a citation for careless driving, which necessarily means you just rear-ended the vehicle. All information will be emailed to you, and I'll print out a sheet of all information reference your vehicle, her vehicle, for your insurance purposes. You have any questions for me?
No.
Okay. On that end, my crash is concluded. Officer Dallas will take over here, okay? Okay.
All right, Stephanie, as you said, okay, the civil crash part of this investigation is over. I'm going to be conducting a DUI investigation, okay? Before I do it, I'm going to read you your rights. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to talk to a lawyer and have him present with you while you're being questioned. If you cannot afford to hire a lawyer, one be appointed to represent you before any questioning if you wish. You can decide anytime to exercise these rights, asking questions, or make any statements. Do you understand your rights, ma'am?
Yep. Hello.
Can you go ahead and get off the phone for me, please?
Yeah.
Ma'am, please hang up. Stephanie, just hang up.
We'll get back.
Okay, so we already know that you're in a crash. Can you explain why I'm smelling that? You can be truthful with me or not, okay? Because I can smell the alcohol on your breath.
I'm a bartender.
All right, your speech is a little slurred, your eyes are glassy and watery, okay? Will you allow me to check your eyes, make sure you're okay to be driving?
That's fine? I have
okay.
Family members coming. No, actually, it's not.
Come on over here.
Can I wait for my mother and my attorney to show up?
Your attorney for what?
Because you just sat there and grabbed my memoranda right, so I'm allowed to have an attorney.
And that's fine. I won't ask you any incriminating questions, okay? But I'm going to go on with conducting my DUI investigation.
But
right?
You showed me my attorney.
I'm asking you, will you do some FSTs for me just to make sure to dispel my suspicion that you may be impaired in driving?
You would still need my attorney present for that, right?
No, I don't.
If I called Jervis Wise right now, would he say the same thing?
I'm telling you right now, it doesn't work that way. I'm doing an investigation. I'm not doing anything incriminating, and I'm not asking any more incriminating if that's what you want, but I am going to conduct an investigation and make sure you're safe to be driving out here.
But if I have someone coming here to pick me up...
It doesn't work that way. You're now detained for the investigation for DUI.
How? And I didn't do anything wrong.
I just explained to you. Your eyes are glassy and watery, okay?
I just came out of
your speech, listen, I can smell the alcohol on your breath,
okay?
And I want to dispel the suspicions that she may be impaired in driving.
Okay.
This woman is so deceptive, but she's actually trying to be clever. Instead of using the usual, I only had two drinks technique, she's using a more advanced technique that is, I work at a bar, therefore that's why I smell like alcohol. But she's going to need a lot more to fool this officer.
So I'm asking, are you going to allow me to look at your eyes to make sure you're okay to be driving?
No.
No? Okay. So are you willing to participate in some fields of body exercises?
I want my attorney.
Are you willing to participate? You don't have a right when it comes to FSTs?
When you
give
me my rights, I'm allowed to have my attorney.
No. Here's the thing. You can have your attorney when it comes to asking you incriminating questions, okay? I'm conducting a DUI investigation.
These are incriminating circumstances.
These are not, okay?
My attorney.
I'm asking you to do FSTs, and it has nothing to do with it. These are voluntary. It's strictly based on you saying yes or no. I can tell you this. Your refusal to do the exercises can be used against you in court, and I have to make a decision based off the totality of the investigation and circumstance right now, rather than not leave you being impaired in driving.
Okay, well, I'm not driving from here, so I'm waiting for my mother to
Well, you were driving. Okay, so I'm going to ask a final time. Are you willing to go through these exercises?
I would rather wait for my mother to come pick me up.
It doesn't work that way. And I need a, I want a direct answer. It's a yes or a no answer.
I'd rather wait for my attorney, if that's
okay.
The case.
All right, I'm going to put you under.
Okay.
Yep, I'll get your shoes.
We'll get the shoes taken care of. Where in the car are they at? Driver's side. From the driver's side, like you set them down.
I didn't put these on tight at all, okay, so don't try to shimmy out of them. I am placing you under arrest for DUI. I'm going to ask, will you be willing to provide me a sample of your breath?
No.
Nope. I got to read you this, okay?
You just did.
No, this is implied consent.
Oh, okay.
Because you said no. Okay. You can read along with me, okay?
Mm-hmm.
I'm now requesting that you submit to a lawful test of your breath for the purposes of determining its alcohol content. If you refuse to take the test I requested of you, your driving privilege will be suspended for a period of 1 year for the first refusal, or 18 months if your driving privilege has been previously suspended, or if you've been previously fined under state statute 327.35215 for refusing to submit to a lawful test of your breath, urine, and blood. Additionally, if you refuse to take the test I requested of you, or if you have been previously fined under state statute 327.35215 for refusal to submit to a lawful test of your breath, urine, or blood, you will be committing a misdemeanor in addition to any other penalties which can be imposed by law. Refusal to submit to the test I requested is admissible in evidence in any criminal proceeding.
Okay.
Do you understand that, Stephanie?
Yeah.
Having that in mind, I'm going to ask a final time, will you be willing to provide me the sample of your breath?
Yeah.
Okay, it is a refusal. 551-1015.
Now, I wonder why she would refuse to do the test. There are some valid reasons where one might want to refuse to do the exercises, but the breathalyzer, if you have nothing to hide, you would be way better off doing the test and then getting clear of your charges, because if you blow under the limit, you're not going to jail. You're going to be released immediately. So it's kind of ridiculous that she doesn't want to. Obviously, she's hiding something. She's extremely lethargic on top of having some attitude. So yeah, she's definitely drunk.
I put my shoes on.
Yes, we're gonna get your shoes. Where are they at in the car?
They're right in the...
Okay, come on over.
Yeah, I'll go there.
Yep. Where's your car at? I don't have a cage in this one.
I'm across the street. I can pull over here behind you.
You have my phone. So
yeah, I got her phone here.
Do
you have a wallet?
Here?
You have a wallet in there?
No.
Okay.
Do you have my phone?
I'm gonna grab your towel from you, okay? And I'll throw that in the car.
Yep.
Is that cool?
Okay.
You don't need it, right?
I need that. Nope.
Okay.
85, can I get a female officer to search?
Six for
five. You want to put your coat in there?
Yeah, because I need to take care of my kid.
Did she really just say, because I need to take care of my kid? Bitch, if you wanted to take care of your kid, you wouldn't be driving drunk. That is one of the most common used excuses by drunk drivers. I gotta take care of my kid. Right after I have to go pee.
Yep, we'll make sure
you
to
can look at my face, though. So my face will do it.
Stephanie, I don't see your shoes over here.
They're either there and they're in the back. You can't miss them. They're black work shoes.
Who do we need to contact?
Kathy.
To make sure it's your kids?
She's just tried to call. Thank you.
Alright, here.
Phone. I don't know why you're jingling your hand and you're worried about me.
What?
I said your hand's shaking and mine's not. Right
I'm
there. Kathy Matos.
Courtney.
Your
what?
Hand's big enough.
Kathy.
You have bigger hands than I do. Come on, dude. Here.
You can
talk
right here on
you can put it to my ear. It's not privilege and I need an attorney. I know my law and I know my right. Okay. It doesn't have to be privilege. So you can take it off speakerphone.
Here we go. Listen, how about this? What we'll do is you can make your phone calls when you get out of jail.
I don't know her number by heart.
Okay. You can take your phone with you and take numbers out of it, okay?
Yeah, that's fine.
All right, hold on. We're trying to get your shoes out of there for you.
My phone's calling. Goes to the car. That's probably why she couldn't hear me. Think about it. It's on Bluetooth. Goes to the car.
Okay.
It would make sense. So I would need to talk to her off Bluetooth. She has my 6-year-old son, so I would think that would be illegal.
What?
There's socks too.
I don't know where the socks are at, but at least you got your shoes, Stephanie.
All right.
Well, if I'm going to go to jail, I want my commissary with me.
Can you just grab your car and pull up behind me?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay. I'll pull it up in front of here. I don't care.
They're coming here right now. It would be great if I told them to just come to the jail to pop me out.
Well, I can do that. I just need to know who we're speaking to. I'm going to put it on speakerphone.
She's just trying to call back. Because
I'm
going to
tell you that
YouTube.
Several people have called before, and a group of people would show up, and I don't know who's being what, you know what I'm saying? So I was trying to work with you, but you want to be
there's only
like
one
that.
Person. I just sat there and said she had my son.
So are you wanting to do that? As long as you're talking on speakerphone, and I'm
but
I'm
when you connect
that.
It on speakerphone, it goes to my Bluetooth, so it has to go to my ear.
Well, we'll move over here a little bit further
it
away.
Work.
Yeah, it does. Bluetooth is like 30 feet.
No, not with mine. Okay. It can literally go inside my house.
Okay, we'll make a call as soon as we can put you in there, okay? And I'll stand by the door there and let you speak and make sure it's your
put
son's
me
okay.
Where? The car's right there.
Yeah. Making sure that
he's
going to put you in one of
the
cages.
You guys are all getting $25 an hour. That's crazy.
It's hard to hear her because she's mumbling a lot, but she is complaining that the officers are paid $25 an hour. Bitch, they should be paid a lot more to have to deal with drunk assholes like you. Personally, there's no amount of money you could give me that would convince me to volunteer to deal with drunk Karens on a daily basis.
Come on. I can't even imagine how many times I've seen you in front of Surfside, arresting people, talking to you.
Are you okay?
Can you take Kathy's number down, please?
Yeah.
Can you take and call them?
Put him over. Put her
wait,
over
they
here.
Need my... Okay.
Yeah, we'll do that. Come. Let's walk over here, okay, to the spot.
I have my son.
Okay. You better make...
You got it? Okay. No, I don't.
Okay, I asked everybody.
Can you call them, please?
I'm calling
now. Okay, thank you.
Hold on.
I don't know. Just whenever they say what my bond is, just bond me out.
Okay. If anything's on you, it's better if we find it.
I have nothing on me.
I don't say the same thing to everybody.
Vagina. Okay. So I think it comes with me.
We gotta do our job and check it out.
You know which one you wanna attach this time with me. Can I sign my car?
We're just going to be taking your car's going to be impounded.
Okay, but my mother can come get it.
No, it's going to be going impounded. Okay. I'm trying to.
So there you have it. Another one arrested. Another one bites the dust. Another drunk driver off the streets. And what really bothers me with this one is that she is so careless. It's like she really thinks she did nothing wrong and she literally just caused an accident. Obviously, she will be committing more crimes in the future. She has so little care for everybody around her, including herself. I wouldn't be surprised if we see her on the channel in the next couple months. So she was arrested for DUI involving property damage. So I guess time will tell how that goes, but there is a lot of evidence against her. First of all, she already caused a crash. She refused to do the field sobriety test. She refused to do the breathalyzer test. So it is looking mighty suspicious. Anyways, thanks for watching, everybody. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel as well as my second channel, Josh Prime 2, where you'll find more awesome videos like this one. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next one.